Hi everybody, this is Nick. Today we're going to walk through some really quick steps that you can use to make a report template in PowerPoint that looks just like this, that you can use over and over and over again and insert new slides based on the look and layout of this slide. And we're going to use the Slide Master to do that. The first thing that we want to do though is I wanted to show you, if you go up to the Home tab here and the Layout menu, you can see all of the different stock templates or the slide layouts. These are called that PowerPoint will have for you. And none of these look like the one that I created right here because I just put in a rectangle and a title and a photo and I moved the text to where I want it to be. One of the telltale signs of using a slide presentation that is not making good use of the actual slide master and the slide layouts from the slide master is this little button right here. It's the reset button. If you click that, it's going to reset the slide that you have on your screen to whatever the master slide layout it's using. So go ahead and reset this and see what happens. I reset it and you can see that the report title goes to the middle, the text goes down here, the text font size goes way up, and then my report header and my photo just kind of stay there because that's not part of any, there's no picture placeholder or there's no design elements like the blue header bar on the actual slide master layout that we have here. If you go to the View tab up here and go to click on Slide Master, this is where you can see all of the layouts. And you can see this layout right here, if I hover over it, it says title slide layout used by slides one. So this is the actual layout that I was, the slide layout that I was using. We'll go back over to the View tab and then Normal View. That's the slide layout that I was using here. So I'm gonna go ahead and just click undo a couple times, or maybe just once to see if we can get that my look and feel back. But now let's go ahead and use the master slides to create a report that will look just like this. So what we need to do is go over to the View tab, back to the Slide Master, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and insert a new slide layout. And you can do this by going up here to the ribbon right here, Insert Layout, or you can right-click and say Insert Slide Master or Insert Layout. You don't want to click Insert Slide Master. That will insert an entirely new master, but this is just going to insert a layout. So we're just going to insert one little layout right there. The other thing I want to do is I want to apply a design grid so that I'm putting everything into nice space. So let's go up to the Bright Slide add-in that we've used before. Click on the Guides feature right here, go to Create Guides and say Add to Master. Now, anytime I'm doing an 8.5 by 11 page, I like to have this laid out so that we have two columns and 11 rows, and then the top and bottom margins are to 0.25 left and right are 0.5, and I think that's pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead and click OK, and you can see that I have my nice guides right here. Now, I don't want the orange guides, those kinds of just come by default in PowerPoint. So I'm gonna drag those off the screen and get rid of them. Now I have my slide title here. That kind of comes standard with any of the slide layouts that you insert. So we're gonna keep that here and I'm just gonna go up here. I'm gonna make sure that it snaps to the grid here, and anything that I do to this slide will apply to that layout in the future. So let's go ahead and just make this text bold. It's already 37.4. Let's just make this 24 point font. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn this font white. And we're going to go ahead and insert a shape. This is going to be my header bar right here. I'm going to make sure that stretches across, and then we're going to right click and send it to the back. And now we have the title right there. I also want to make sure there's no line, there's no outline on this. So the shape outline, I'm just going to say no outline. So I wanted to put some text right here on that left margin. So let's go ahead and say insert placeholder, and I'm just going to say insert text. And then anything that you do here, we're gonna insert that text. And this, the text styles come from the slide master. So this is the parent slide right here. Anything here is going to apply to this text here unless I kind of hard code the differences. So I'm not gonna mess with the slide master in this video, but we are just going to update this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to make sure that it's not a bulleted list. We'll see if that works for other things. I'm gonna delete all the levels of text because I don't really need those. I just need one level of text for this box, and I'm gonna make sure that it's 14 points, and I'm gonna make sure that it's pretty dark. It's already applied automatic, so it's pretty dark, so we're gonna keep that there. I'm gonna make sure that this text box goes all the way there. The other thing we wanna do for PowerPoint, we need to make sure that the text box properties are set so that the text does not auto shrink. So let's go to right click and format shape, and under this little size and position right here, we'll go to text box features. We're going to say do not auto fit. So that's going to make sure that the text will always be 14 point font, nice and consistent, and it won't go down if I type in more text in the box. Now let's go ahead and put a photo. But I'm not going to add a single photo. I'm going to add a placeholder for a photo. So over here on the Insert tab, let's go over to the Slide Master tab here. Insert placeholder, we're going to say Insert Picture. So this is going to be a place for a picture placeholder, and I'm going to drag that all the way to the side of this, to the right side of the screen. And then anything you type in here in the box will show up in your layout. So I'm just going to say Insert Picture. Insert Picture, oops. That's nice. And I make sure that picture goes all the way to the side because I want the photo to be kind of this full bleed photo all the way to the edge. I don't want to see all of the borders on the photo. And now let's go ahead and insert one more Slide Master, one more text placeholder. And we will do the text placeholder right here. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to apply this text. I'm going to go ahead and use the Format Painter. And I'm just going to go ahead and apply that there. And that gives me that top level. And then I'm going to go ahead and delete all the other levels. So now, when I go back to my normal view, we could go ahead and insert a new slide. And you can see we have the custom layout right here on the top. And now everything that I did in that photo, in that Slide Master layout, will apply to my new layout. Now if I wanted to go ahead and just copy this picture, Control C, let's go ahead and punch it into this picture placeholder right here. It fills the area of that picture placeholder. I could go ahead and type in equals lorem. Open, close parenthesis, give some sample text right there. It does continue to keep that bulleted list property. I think all of the text placeholders will do that. So if you wanted the bullet list, you could keep it. But if you want to just get rid of the list, just go up to the paragraph styles and click uncheck that bullet list. And then you can have a lot of things. We'll do equals rand, open, close, the quick brown fox. Pretty cool. So there's a little way that you can create a standardized template page for your one-pager reports and have it be updatable there in PowerPoint. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.